Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik, and today I'm pleased to demonstrate Qlik's latest product release for November 2019. This time, instead of a quick synopsis of the features, I decided to spend a bit more time showing you them in action. This release introduces a number of new capabilities across our product spectrum. With Qlik Sense, there's new visualizations, expanded data connectivity, enhanced security and subscription management, and we're including a new unified analytics experience with QlikView. And this time around, I'll be diving into Attunity, and I'll show you what's new in Attunity 6.5. There are also enhancements to Qlik Sense Mobile, Qlik Insight Bot, Qlik EnPrinting, and the Qlik Associative Big Data Index, so please be sure to check out our release notes. Let's take a look. So the first one we'll talk about is Accumulation, which is an additional option that's been added to the bar chart, line chart, combo chart, and table. Now to demonstrate this feature, I already have an app created and data is loaded. I created some master visualizations already just to represent the data values. So for example, right now, this KPI object shows you that we have 7.12 million in total sales for the year 2018. Now I also have a bar chart here, which calculates sales by month for 2018. And you can see January through December. And right now, each bar is the same, showing the total sales for each month. I have not turned on the accumulation option yet. So let's unlink our master visualization and have full access to the properties. And you can see now for the orange bar, which is going to represent accumulated sales, we have an option called modifier. If I click that, I get presented with a drop-down box where I can select any modifier. Now, in this case, we have one called accumulation. I assume in the future we'll have additional calculations added here. So when I select accumulation, we're presented with a range. In this case here, we have 12 steps for 12 months. You don't have to select custom. You could choose full, in this case here, using the full range. And as you can see here, the blue, once again, is representing the total sales for each month. And now the orange is representing the accumulated sales, basically adding the previous month's sales to the current month, and continuing to do so all the way up to December 2018, where we total 7.12 million. Now, if we wanted to also represent a rolling period, we could then choose the custom range. And if I wanted to do, for example, a 3-month rolling period, I could put in steps 3, and then you can see that my accumulated calculation changes, therefore just maintaining and tracking 3 months. So we have January, February, and March. And then once we get over to April, basically the value from January will fall off in that accumulation, and that will repeat this throughout the year. And that's how you do a rolling period. Okay, so the next thing we're going to cover is the MECO chart, something that's been requested by many customers. Now, the MECO chart is a new visualization added to our chart library. Also goes by other names such as Merrimeco or the mosaic plot or even the Mondrian diagram. It's basically useful for showing a percentage of a whole or shares. Think of it as a 100% bar chart that has two dimensions. And to represent that, I actually have created two visualizations here. We have cost by type and vendor in a stacked bar and cost by type and vendor in a tree map. So the stacked bar is showing me height, and the tree map is showing me width. So for example, yes, I can see that the parts category is dominating the particular costs here with these individual vendors. And then now looking over at the parts category here, I can see that game liquidation is also contributing to a large amount of the cost within the parts category. Okay, and you can kind of see that here too as well, but it's not as easily interpreted. Now watch what happens when I bring in a MECO chart. So here is the same information now relayed in a MECO chart. Let me go into analysis mode and make this larger. And so now within one chart, think of combining the stacked bar chart and the tree map, and you can very easily see the breakdown of the whole within both dimensions for type and vendor. And this is represented using the height and the width for the cost contributions for those related dimensions. So for example, I can see that Amazon, looking at its height and its width, are dominating equipment costs and are my second contributor to the overall total costs when compared to the parts category. And it's clear that all parts, in this case, overall dominate every category, with game liquidation contributing to almost 50% of my parts cost. And that parts overall dominates everything else, contributing to 60.6%. So a very simple, clean, easy way to interpret these dimensions and data values. Okay, the next one is a fairly quick one. This is table styling. So let me go into edit mode. You can see I have a table here. When I select my table, I can select a column. And one of the things we have added is the ability to perform text alignment. So here we have left, now we have center, now we have right. And you can do that for each of the columns simply by flipping the switch and then selecting the alignment. And then if you go to appearance, you'll notice that under the presentation tab, there's a section for styling. You can change the header font size, the header font color, as well as the content font size. Now we've been adding more styling capabilities, so more options will follow with each release. Okay, so the last thing I'd like to show you in regards to the visualization capabilities that have been added to November 2019 is we made some improvements to the Trellis container to now support two dimensions. Now, the Trellis container is an object that is available in the Qlik visualization bundle under custom objects. And if you recall, when we added this capability in a prior release, you're able to select a master visualization and combine it with a dimension. So for example, if I was to choose in this case, let's say year, and our master visualization would be sales by category. In this case here, just to show you what it looks like, if we go to our master visualization, that's what sales by category looks like. Now I can create a container that has each visualization for each year. So here I'll just select sales by category, and now we can see sales by category for each year. Now the improvement is we now support two dimensions. So you can create kind of like a grid view of this particular container. So here we have years. So now in my field list, I'm going to choose quarter, and we'll add quarter. And now you can see that quarters are going across the top and years will go down on the side. Now, if you get a too many dimensions value, that's just because it's configured for a maximum number of charts is 8. Just increase this, let's say 25 for now. And now we can see the appropriate year and quarter for sales by category. So a quick update on the Qlik Sense connectivity within our cloud-based editions of Qlik Sense. We continue to improve that by adding additional connectivity, such as with this release, we've added the Dropbox connector, SAP SQL connector, and have made improvements to Google BigQuery to now support Google BigQuery Storage API. Now, another new feature that we added to the Qlik Sense cloud-based editions is the ability to upload and consume QlikView documents directly from the Qlik Sense interface. So here, as I select Create and Upload App, you can see drop your files here or browse. In this case here, I'm just going to browse to where I have some QlikView documents. I'll select the movies database. I can choose where I would like to put the document. I can put it into Mike's space and then click Upload. And now you can see once this app is uploaded, it is available right here and functions just like a QlikView app. And this is just phase one of a two-phase approach. The first phase being the ability to upload the QlikView document into the environment. And then the second one will be the ability to automate the actual publishing from a publisher to the actual Qlik Sense environment. So in regards to Qlik Sense Business, I'm really excited to show you some of the improvements our team has made to user account and subscription management. So if you're in the Qlik Sense Business interface, you'll notice that you can get to your account settings by going to the settings location in your user profile, and then there'll be a link for account settings. And this will bring you to the My Qlik portal, where you can view your profile, change your password, and also add multi-factor authentication. So in this example here, if I click Setup, and then click Setup Now, and then you'll have to set up a multi-factor authentication piece of software on your mobile device. Now, in this case here, I have my iPhone set up, and I'm using Okta Verify. And I'm just going to hold my phone up and add an account and scan. And you'll see it's now given me a code for my tenant, 993956. I enter in that code. I click Continue. And now I have my multi-factor authentication all set. Now, other improvements include the ability to purchase Qlik Sense Business using a credit card. I'm going to put in my subscriptions. You can see I have 24 of 30 days remaining. I click Purchase. We're just going to select two seats. Click Continue. And then enter in the credit card information. And now you can see my plan price, my number of users, my subscription start and end dates, payment terms, and the total. Now I click Pay. And now my payment is successful. And now I can manage my subscription directly from this location link. And I can add seats at any time. Okay, so in regards to Attunity, and yes, I'm not just a Qlik Sense guy. I dabbled a little with Attunity as well. And we have some new features and capabilities to talk about. The first one being new endpoint data connections that have been added for source and targets. So just as a quick example, in my source endpoints here, you can see we have a new source for a Salesforce has been added, as well as MongoDB. And then we've added two new cloud targets, one being Google Cloud BigQuery, and then the other being Microsoft Azure Databricks. Now within the Attunity Enterprise Manager, you have the ability to manage all these endpoints from one simple location, so an aggregated view. And then we've also added some security improvements. So please refer to our documentation to learn more about what's new in 6.5. Now, one other thing we've added also is additional API calls. So with 6.5, Attunity now supports API calls for the most popular developing languages such as REST, Microsoft.NET, and Python. I have a couple of these configured in a Postman interface that I can use to demonstrate this, just to give you a quick example. So first, I'm just going to log into the Attunity Enterprise Manager and establish a session utilizing this API endpoint here. Now, once my session is established, I can do things such as get the task list. So just to give you a quick example, if I flash back to the web console, you can see I have a new task here called MySQL to Snowflake. So if we go back to Postman, and we do ascend on our task list, you can see it comes back with MySQL to Snowflake as a result. Now, obviously, the results are formatted in JSON. Developers will know what to do with this when integrating these with their applications. Now, those are just simple get methods. Now, I could also do a post. So this particular task loads data from my transactional database in MySQL and loads it to my data warehouse in the cloud in Snowflake. So here I'm going to select my start task API and I'm going to click send. And it's executing this task right now. If we switch over to my Snowflake console and we preview the data, you can see currently there isn't any data here. We can see that the state is now running. And then we're just going to give it a few more seconds and I previewed and now my data has loaded. So I have actually used a REST API with a POST method to kick off an Attunity task to load my data warehouse. Okay, so just some other cool things that are available now in Attunity 6.5. Well, that's it for this video. If you want a deeper dive on these highlights and more with each release, be sure to sign up and subscribe for our Qlik Insider webinar series, with the next one scheduled on November 20th. If you want to be notified when more videos such as this are posted and are viewing from YouTube, click the bell icon below. We want to hear from you, so tell me in the comments what you think. Don't forget to check out these other great resources to learn more about Qlik and Qlik Sense. And please remember to join the conversation with myself and others in the Qlik community. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you on the next video. Take care.